say that, buddy.
You ready?
Ho, ho, ho,
with
a
very old
floor
and a very
old floor.
Good.
Yes. That's a volunteer for next year.
Soon. Yeah, I reckon. All right.
Yep.
Hello.
Yes, it won't pick up.
There it is.
We're live.
Testing. Oh, is this it going out on Zoom, is it?
I think that's the sign that we're ready. And with that, the rain stops.
Yay!
He said,
hallelujah.
Hopefully.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Well, first of all, are we going live now?
It's been live.
Oh gosh, you've seen us all shooting around. In which case, for those who have joined us physically and those who have joined us online, thank you so much for being here. Somebody's trying to phone me. Thank you so much for being here. It's really great to see you. Mike, that might be a delivery. It's probably Santa. For your mother.
It's got a doppelganger over there.
Thank you so much for being here. Hopefully everybody has got one of these to be able to see from. We're outside because of all the COVID stuff, but on the other hand, it means that we're able to sing without masks and stuff like that. For those who are joining us at home, if you want to download the carols that we're going to sing, you can do that by going on the church website. That's www.newcreation.co.uk.
Org.uk.
Org.uk. I never get it quite right. www.newcreationchurches.org.uk. And you will find the carol service, the Chris Dingle service, and everything.
Or you
like
can
that.
Scan this QR code.
Or scan that QR code if you're ever so clever with technology. We've had to do that since having all these COVID tests and stuff, haven't we?
Yeah.
I've never really did QR codes very much in the past. Right. So, I would like to say a very big thank you just before we start. Thank you to everyone from the youth group who will be sharing in the service. Thank you to Eric for playing, and to all those who helped set everything up. And we'll make the best of what we've got. Would that be all right?
Yeah.
Good. And I hope you enjoy. So without further ado, we're going to sing Come and Join the Celebration. It's a Very Special Day. Thank you, Eric. You all right over there, brother?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Yep. Yeah. That's not on here. Oh, is it? Yeah.
Three. Three and a chorus.
It is on.
Have been working on a play which of course was provisionally going to be indoors and everything like that, but they've moved outside. You're nothing but a flexible group of players, aren't you?
Yes!
There you go. Waistcoat and shit. You alright?
Are you ready?
Are you ready? Kirsty, love, are you able to move just to one side? Oh no, you can't really move to one side a bit. We need to move the lamp a bit so they've got a bit of light on them. There we go.
Better?
Yeah. Well done, you. Is that alright? Is that alright, Emma? Right, my friends. Is that Penny? You've got a bit of light. I'm going to hand over to the youth group for their special Chris Dingle play. Can you give them a round of applause?
Yay! Yay.
Oh my goodness, it was such a good film. It was amazing. I really liked it.
So, how was the film then?
It was amazing. This kid goes back in time and saves the world.
That actually sounds really cool. Oh, this is my memory box.
Wow, what's in it?
Oh, some very special items. Each item in here has a really special meaning about a really fantastic story.
I wish I could hear that, although it probably won't be as exciting as the film.
Oh, don't you be so quick to greatest story ever told.
Really?
Yes. Would you like me to tell you?
Can you, can you remember it?
Yeah, my memory's not that good, but I've got the things in here that will help me to remind me.
What is that?
This is a Christingle. And each part has a special meaning. But I do it slightly differently, so each thing reminds me of something. Shall we start with the orange?
Many years ago, God made the world. He made day and night, then land and sea, plants and trees. He then wanted to create animals to live in the world. He was really pleased with what he had done, but felt something was missing, so he made us to help him take care of the world. Then God looked down and was really pleased with what he saw. Although he was happy, he wasn't surprised when the people he created decided to try and live their lives however they wanted, instead of following God's ways. This made him very sad, as he knew it would mean they would miss out on his best hopes and dreams for them. But God had a cunning plan.
So the orange is like the earth?
Yes. Let's see what the first item is in the box that helps us represent the orange.
What is that?
This is soil.
I thought you were going to burst into something there, isn't it?
This represents the earth. You see, God wants us to take care of it because it's a beautiful planet, but actually we don't always do a really good job. There are four sticks, but on the edge of end of each stick are some sweets.
I like sweets.
I know you do.
Tell me.
But these are sort of like the angels, because they hover over the earth telling everybody the good news.
What good news?
What? Let's see what our story says.
God sent an angel down to earth with a message for a young girl called Mary. Now, seeing an angel in front of her really surprised Mary, but she was also very scared. The angel told her, "Do not be afraid, for I bring wonderful news from God." The angel told her that she was to have a baby, God's own son, and she was to call him Jesus, meaning God with us. Well, although Mary was frightened, she trusted God and told the angel that she would do what God wanted her to do. An angel also appeared to Joseph. And although he had doubts about marrying Mary, the angel told him what God had said and that he should take care of her.
Wow, imagine an angel coming to visit. How cool would that be? I wonder what could be in the box.
Well, in here, yeah. There's a halo, and this represents the angels. And this is to remember that the angels told everybody about the good news of Jesus.
Oh. Do we see the angels again?
Just wait and see.
So how about the first stick?
Well, this one always reminds me of Mary and Joseph. And I think it sort of represents bravery.
Bravery?
Yes, you see, Mary and Joseph were really brave. They had to trust that God would keep them safe.
Does that make them the heroes of the story?
Yes, I suppose it does. But let's listen to the next part of the story.
Mary and Joseph had to travel a long way before they arrived in Bethlehem.
Yeah.
Happened. Mary gave birth to Jesus. The little
boy fell asleep in Mary's arms, and she wrapped him in cloths and laid him in a manger on some clean straw.
You sing Away in a Manger, everybody. You'll find it at the bottom of the page. Been born. King Herod was a little bit angry,
So he asked the chief priests and teachers of the law if it was true. They told Herod that a baby was to be born in Bethlehem, who had become the king of the Jews. King Herod asked the wise men to come back and tell him exactly where Jesus could be found, so that he could go and worship him too. But King Herod didn't really want to worship Jesus at all. He was jealous and frightened at the prospect of a rival king, and wanted Jesus dead. The wise men followed the star to Bethlehem. When it seemed to stop and shine directly down upon the place where Jesus laid in the manger. When the wise men entered, they found Jesus with Mary, but they bowed down and worshipped him. They then gave Jesus the gifts that they had bought for him of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. That night, the wise men were warned in a dream by God not to go back to King Herod. So they returned home to their countries in the east by a different way.
So Herod really was a baddie then?
I suppose he was. He was only interested in staying king, and no one was going to stop him.
But the wise men were cool. Imagine travelling all that way on camels, following the star.
They must have really believed in that new baby.
What's in the box?
It's a crown. This is to remind us that God wants us to be like the kings and to follow him wherever he goes.
What's next?
Well, the candle, which is the most important part.
Why?
This represents Jesus.
But why a candle?
Because he is the light of the world and it shows us the light.
I don't understand.
Just listen.
As Jesus grew up, he spent his life healing people and teaching them about God's love. He looked after the poor, the sick, the injured, and the outcast. He taught us to love one another as he loved us.
Wow, he sounds amazing. What's in the box to remind us of this great man? Straw? Now I really don't understand. Why straw?
All the gifts, the tinsel, the lights, the food are lovely. But the true meaning of Christmas is Jesus. Sometimes we need to leave everything behind us and go back to the manger.
Like in the film I watched?
Well, unlike your film, this is all true.
Jesus was a real person?
Yeah.
Well, so what does the ribbon remind us of?
Well, the ribbon is there to remind us of what Jesus did for each and every one of us. You see, he died on the cross and rose again to show us how much God loved us.
He died?
Yes, you see, that was God's cunning plan. So in the box are two pieces of wood nailed together. You see, we can't have the manger without the cross. We need both to know that God's love for us is greater than the universe.
What, even for me?
Yeah.
What happened next?
I think that is a story for another day.
Can we give the guys a big round of applause?
Oh, fantastic. Yay.
There's a song which become really important to the youth group over time, and Jamie's going to sing it. But just reflect on the idea that this person on the cross and the person born at Christmas is there for you as the youth group, and Jamie sing this.
Barriers, the taller I become.
group taking that song to heart is it's almost like God speaking to all of us, those who are physically here, those who are at home, and indeed to everybody on the planet, about his love for you and about his love for the world, even in the midst of all that we're going through. So thank you, Kaz, thank you, youth group, thank you one and all. Do you want to just sort of put your head over the top or something just to say hello? There you go. There you go. There are real people behind there as well as the puppets. Wonderful. Shall we sing our next carol together? It's the Calypso Carol. See him lying on a bed of straw. Very appropriate given that that's where we ended with our song. And as we do that, what I'd like to encourage you to do, if you would be willing, is actually come out and pick up a piece of straw from the, probably the straw on the ground is a bit damp now, but the straw in the manger, take it home with you, put it in your pocket, and you know when you get your keys out or your mobile phone or whatever, when you go to bed tonight or tomorrow morning, just hold it and go, oh yeah, I remember what Christmas is all about. And it can be there for as long as you would like it to be. So we'll sing this carol, and as you come, please come and help yourselves if you'd be so kind. Thank you very much.
Go, Jane.
One last thing though, obviously being outside, we didn't know what the weather was going to be like with all of the, we had the rain, but hopefully not too much wind. We could have probably lit Chris Dingles outside, couldn't we? But that's why we gave you, pardon? Do you want to do that? Go and find us some paper. Nothing if not present. So would you like to form yourselves into a big circle? But you've got your tea lights as well, yes?
Yeah, they are.
Pardon?
No, he's got it. It's only joking. Oh, that's nice.
And if you want to grab yourselves into, leave your seats where they are, and we'll just gather ourselves into a big circle. And obviously, you can focus on me. I'll stand here. Okay.
No, you're all right, Cody. You can walk in front.
There you go, love. So, if you don't want to be in the... Obviously, we're trying to film it so that everybody can join in. So, if you've got a Chris Dingle at home, you've come and collected a pack. If you've forgotten and you happen to be out wandering around Congsbury over the next few days, we'll make sure there's plenty of packs actually in the church. So, just call down at church, pick up a pack, go home. Make your Chris Dingle. All you need is an orange. Then you can make your own Chris Dingle and light it and eat the sweets and be part of the story. Here we go. There we go. Are they not? We'll give it a little try. I just thought it was actually getting to the point where... Eric, could you be so kind as to pass me one over, bro? We're having a party next year. What, love?
Oh, yeah.
Have you got your? Have you all got your Chris Dingles?
Yes, sir.
Have you got them lit?
No.
Not easily.
Keep blowing out.
If you've got, if they keep blowing out, use your nightlight. What I love, total chaos. It's great. I love it. You all right there? Hello. So, what I love is whether you've got a little nightlight or whether you've got your Chris Dingle, I believe this light is a light within you every single day of your life. And whether we notice it or not, it's always there. In good days and tough days, in rainy days and sunny days, this light is both in you and everybody you'll ever meet. And I love that. And of course, on a day like today when we celebrate Christmas and we celebrate Chris Dingle, it's a wonderful way of looking around you. I would love everybody who's joining us online to be able to see, see what we can see here, which is everybody's light is lit within them. And that's why Jesus came and why we're still talking about it 2,000 years later. We've got a little poem which is going to be read. You ready, Alex? Just hold the microphone nice and close and go for it.
Back to the manger. What if you had the hearts of the innkeeper, allowing the weary travellers to stay? Or the shepherd's ears that listened intently as a star guided them along their way? What if we were as willing as the wise men to follow until the Father was near? Or if we all had the voices of angels telling his story to whoever may hear? What if we had Mary's bravery as she fled, or Joseph's loyalty to stay at her side? What a wonderful world it would be if we all followed Jesus' guide. Each of us are works in progress, learning when we're young and old. That is how we can all become a part of the greatest story ever told. Where a story starts is important, so make sure it doesn't get lost. Because if you don't remember the crib, you will never remember the cross.
Thank you, Alex. Bless you. So have a good look around you. I love this moment. I hold on to it every year until we meet again and share Chris Dingle. It's good, isn't it? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Very good.
And all being well, we'll be inside next year, hey? That would be good. My friends, thank you so much. After three, would you like to blow your Chris Dingles out? One, two, three. It's like happy birthday, yeah. We've got one more carol to sing, everybody. And please come back to your seats. We've got one more carol to sing. This is called Christmas Calypso. And Eric, are you playing it? Or you are playing it? Oh, brilliant. This is a carol that many of the children at primary school know and love. So, Eric, if you've been so kind as to play the tune through for us. If you don't know how it goes, this is a new one, everybody. And we hope you enjoy. It's called Christmas Calypso.
I'll play right through.
So, return the power switch. Said we would like this one. He went, sorry, what? I don't know that one. He thought he knew every carol in the book, but it's one that the children sing in school, so we look forward to that. We're going to wind everything up now, but just before we have, we wish you a Merry Christmas. I just would like to say thank you so much for being here. My friends, if you've just joined us, come and help yourselves to a Christingle and all the rest of it. You're very much part of the party. Thank you ever so much for coming. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves. It's really great. Lovely to see so many children here and so many adults as well. And well, let's just bow our heads and we'll say a short prayer and then we'll sing We Wish You a Merry Christmas. God, I thank you for people everywhere as they gather to celebrate Christmas this year. We pray for those who perhaps are celebrating it on their own, who perhaps find this life very difficult. We hope that your light will come into theirs and their darkness and into our world again this Christmas. We pray for people in Bethlehem who are celebrating their Christmas there, the place where you were born. And we ask your blessing upon this community and indeed upon all the different communities around the world, that we too may glimpse something of your wonder and your love. We pray for family and we pray for strangers. We pray for those working in our hospitals, and we pray for those in our families who look after us and care for us. And we thank you that you were born in a manger just for you and people like me. We ask all these prayers in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
So we're going to close up with "We Wish You a Merry Christmas" after three. One, two. Oh, you're good. Wonderful Christmas wherever you are and whoever you're sharing it with. God bless. Bye for everyone at home. Thank you so much for joining us. We've loved it.